Hi guys, so in today's video we're going to be doing how I groom my rabbit routine. And I'm sorry about the lighting, as you can tell on the outside, but I just felt that it would be better to do it out here than inside. So what we're going to do first, I'm going to show you all the utensils that I'll be using in this video. So I have this comb. It's just a regular old comb, nothing special about it. And then I have this little kid's toothbrush, which I like to use like on their face, and it helps get all that hair off of it, or off of them. Sorry if he's trying to run away. And then I have this comb, or this brush. It's kind of hard to see it. Which is a dog brush, but it works really good for them. And then I have this puppy brush, which is good for getting the top coat off. And then, sorry, Effie, come here. I have these cat nail clippers. And then also a good thing to have is treats, just to keep them occupied. So I'm gonna get some treats out for her. And I just like to put a pile somewhere, so I'm going to put them right here. And so the first thing I will be using is the comb. And I just kind of, you don't want it like right straight down on their skin. You just want to do it kind of slanted. And this helps get all of the under coat stuff out of the other fur. So you just brush and I don't think I'm going to be clipping their nails in this video just because it is getting a little hot outside and I don't want them to be out here for too long. So yep, you just brush. And she's trying to get away. Her hind, you can't really see her hind from here, but it does get pretty bad. So I'm going to be doing that. And also, you don't want to be ripping on their fur because their hair or their skin is really thin, and so it can like tear and get cut really easily. Make it easy. You don't want to use anything too sharp. She's really wanting to play, so I should have done this after playtime. But as you can see, the comb does get quite a bit off. And part of the reason why I'm doing this outside is I can just let the hair go anywhere and it's not going to matter if it's not in the house. Cool. And so the next one I'm going to be using is this red one, the dog comb, but I bought it for the rabbit specifically. So yep, you just brush it. Show you her hind end. Hey, you're okay. So yep, just brush. You don't want to brush this way because her fur is going this way, so you don't want to go like that with the brush. Brushing. You kind of want to work it all over their body if you can. Oftentimes it's a lot easier to use your hands to get all the fur off. So that's what I'm going to be doing, and it kind of helps calm them down. Let's know that nothing's going to happen to them. And as you can see, if you use your hands, a lot of fur comes off. It's actually like flying all over the place. I'm glad I did this outside and not in the house somewhere. Effie, oh my gosh. So I'm not going to do her completely because she is kind of getting antsy. Now I'm gonna do Bun Bun. I don't really know how he's gonna react to doing this outside, because I usually do it with him inside, like in my room or in my bathroom. So yeah, it's actually his first time not being outside, but being groomed outside. So we're just gonna do the same thing we did with Effie. Try and walk away. With him, I actually use more of my hands than the brushes. Just because he likes that a bit more. And Bun Bun was is a rescue, so he wasn't really. When I first got him, he wasn't really used to being groomed. He loved being pet and stuff, so that's what we do with him. We just use our fingers. And I'm actually going to use the puppy brush on him. A little bit. Just to help with all the flyaways. Just brushing. I've never really given him banana treats because he's never really liked them. Oh. Or banana chips, I should say. And then the face. Just a little kid's toothbrush again. They're also good for their ears because it's not really hard. And he likes his face being pet, so he's okay. And then also it's really good if you, sorry, it's really hard to see. You do it on their tail as well. Because the tail is pretty, like I've learned that my rabbits don't really like their tails being brushed. So I just use this. And as you can see, it like really works well. So I'm just going to use the puppy brush again. again, that gets a lot of the hair off. And you want to be gentle again because it's really, really easy to tear their skin. And I see in a lot of videos that people, when they're grooming their rabbits, they go like this. Like they use the comb and like go the opposite way that their hair is going, and you don't really want to do that because it's not good on them. So you just, and he molts too. One of the nephews left, so there's a lot more hair coming off of him. He's getting there. Similar to the way that you would with a cat or a dog, just not as harsh. And I'm not saying that people groom their dogs pretty harsh. And sorry about all the background noise. There's a lot of construction going around near my house. They're actually building like an entire new neighborhood. Basically how you brush them. I will clip their nails out here again. So what I do when I clip his nails, he's probably not going to hold it for me. Typically people lay him on their back. I like to just clip off the tip of the nail. And I find that cat nail clippers, yeah, tend to work better than the ones actually meant for bunnies and guinea pigs. So I'm actually gonna hold them. He likes being held more than being on the table, so I'm just gonna do that. So yeah, just clip. And make sure you don't go down too far, because like dogs and cats, they do have a quick, which is basically where all their blood vessels are in their nails. So you just wanna take it a little bit off at a time. And it has been a while since I've done their nails, so his nails are pretty long. And this is also a good time to sort of look your bunnies over for any health issues. Make sure there's nothing on them. And yeah, so that's how you do it.
That's how you completely groom your bunny.
And so yeah, remember to hit that like button. Remember to subscribe and comment down below what I should do next. Bye.